हेलो स्टूडेंट, आई एम प्रोफेसर पल्लवी देवकाते वेलकम्स यू इन सिक्स लेक्चर ऑफ इलेक्टिव इकोन 354 कोर्स टाइटल इज एग्री बिजनेस मैनेजमेंट. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी स्टडीड स्टेप्स इन एस्टेब्लिशमेंट ऑफ एग्रो बेस्ड इंडस्ट्रीज. इन दिस सेशन वी स्टडी एग्रीकल्चरल वैल्यू चेन. So we see one by one different points in value chain analysis. Before starting actual value chain analysis, we come to know what is meant by value. So as in econ 1-to-1, that is principles of agricultural economics, we already see this value concept. So value means it is the total amount that buyers are willing to pay for the farm produce, that is called as value. Or another definition, that is value of a commodity is nothing but the purchasing power of that particular commodity in exchange for other commodity, that is called as value. Okay, so there is slight difference between value and price. So as we see the value, it is the purchasing power of commodity in exchange of other commodity, and price means when value is expressed in terms of money, that is called as price. Okay, after value we see next, that is value creation. Okay, so value creation, or it is also called as value addition. So value creation creates the added value which leads to competitive advantage. Ultimately added value also create a higher profitability for an organization. So this value creation, it's add the value to product and gives maximum profit to that particular farmer. For example, value addition in case of agricultural commodity, that means after harvesting, if there is grading, sorting is there, then it also added value to that particular product. Also processing, then packing are also included in value creation or value addition. We see in short introduction about value chain analysis. So this value chain analysis is also known as Porter's value chain analysis, because this Mitchell Porter was developed this concept of value chain analysis. The Mitchell Porter, in his book called as Competitive Advantage, explained the value chain analysis as that value chain is the collection of activities that are performed by a company to create the value for its customer. That is called as value chain analysis. So in short, value chain analysis is nothing but it is the all activities that are involved in addition of value to the product, that is called as value chain analysis. This value chain analysis is used as a tool for identifying activities within and around the farm and relating these activities to assessment of competitive strength. Okay, so this value chain, it is a tool which are used for identification of activities within and around the farm. Okay, after that we see the definition of value chain analysis. So value chain analysis is the process of dividing various activities of business in primary and support activities and analyzing them, keeping in mind their contribution towards the value creation to the final product, that is called as value chain analysis. Okay, so this value chain analysis, it is a process. This process divides the whole activities of any business into primary activity and support activity, and also analyze that particular activities in creation of value in the final product, that is called as value chain analysis. Okay, after definition of value chain analysis, next one, that is classification of value chain. So Porter divide this value chain activities into two major activities. In that first activity, that is primary activities, and second one, that is supporting activity. Okay, So these primary activities, basically these primary activities are directly related with the flow of product to the consumer. Okay, that means these primary activities are directly related with that particular product, and supporting activity that sustain the primary activities. Okay, so these primary activities are directly related to flow of product to the consumer, whereas these supporting activities, it facilitate the primary activities or help the primary activities in the value addition process. Okay, after primary and secondary activity classification of value chain, we see the Porter's Bone diagram for value chain. Okay, so for value chain analysis, Porter developed this Bone diagram. Okay, in this Bone diagram, we see here at the base of diagram there are primary activities, and these primary activities included different sub activities such as inbound logistic, operations, outbound logistic, marketing and sales and services. So these are the five activities which are included in primary activities. These are directly related with that particular product or value addition process. Next one, that is supporting activities. So on upper side of that particular Bone diagram, we see the supporting activities, and the supporting activities are seen from lower level to higher level. Okay, so in supporting activities, first activity, that is procurement, second activity, that is technological development, then human resource management, and last activity, that is firm infrastructure. So these are the value chain analysis Bone diagram of Porter. It include primary and supporting activity. Okay, so next we see in detail about this primary and supporting activity. So under this primary activity, as we see in Porter's Bone diagram, it include inbound logistic, operations, outbound logistic, marketing, sales and services. Okay, so we see one by one these primary activities. In that first one, that is inbound logistic. Okay, so this inbound logistic include the range of activities like receiving, storing and distribution. Okay, so in this inbound logistic, it related with receiving of that particular raw material, then storing of raw material and distribution of raw material in different section of that particular processing unit or organization. This inbound logistic make the available goods and services for the operational process, and some of those activities are material handling, transportation, stock control, etc. Okay, while studying of that particular inbound logistic, we consider some points. In that first one, that is soundness of material and inventory control system is most important, and second one, that is efficiency of raw material warehousing activities. Okay, so in inbound logistic, we considered the activities which are related with receiving of that particular raw material, then storing of that particular raw material, and finally distribution of raw material into different section of that particular operational unit. Okay, next activity, that is marketing and sales. It makes the consumer and user aware of the product or services so that they are able to purchase it. Okay, so this marketing and selling include the sale, administration, advertising, selling, etc. Okay, so this marketing and sale activities, it include all activities like advertising, promotion, sale, marketing research, public relationship, etc. in that particular marketing and sale activity. They perform to make the customer aware of product and services and create the demand for that particular product. This all comes under this marketing activity. Okay, so this marketing activity include advertising, promotion, sale of that particular product, then marketing research, public relationship, then also demand creation are included under this marketing and sale activity. Okay, while studying this marketing and sale activity, we consider some of the points in that. First one, that is effectiveness of market research to identify the customer segment and need of that particular customer. Okay, so this is the first point, that is market research. After that, next one, that is innovation in the sale and promotion and advertising. Okay, there may be some innovations in sale, promotion and advertising. Next one, evolution of alternate distribution channel is also considered while studying this marketing and sale activity. Next one, that is motivation and competence of sale force. And last point, that is development of an image of quality and favorite reputation with the customer. So these all included under marketing activity. Okay, after marketing activity, next activity, that is services. Okay, so this service activity help in improve the effectiveness or efficiency of primary activities. Okay, so this service means the services which are provided to the customer so as to improve or maintain the value of that particular product. Okay, this service activity include different types of services like financing services, then after sale services, that's all. Okay, while studying this service activity, we see some of the important points in that. First one is promptness of attention to consumer complaints. Second one is appropriateness of warranty and guarantee policies. And third one, that is ability to provide replacement parts and repair services. Okay, so these all included under service activities. Okay, so all these activities are covered under primary activities which are directly related with flow of product, that is inbound logistic operation. Third one is outbound logistic, marketing and sale, and last one is service activity. After service activity, we see next major activity in value chain, that is support activity. Okay, after inbound logistic, next activity, that is operations. So this operation is nothing but the processing activity. So these activities transforming raw input into the final product which is ready for sale is termed as a operation. That means this operations activity include transformation of raw material into the final product which is made available to the final consumer. Okay, so this operation activities include machining, assembling, packing of that particular material are covered under this operation. Okay, so this operation activities include machining, that means whole processing, then assembling of that particular final product, and last one is packing of that particular product. While studying of this operation activity, we considered some points in that. First one is productivity of equipment compared with that key competitors. Okay, while studying of this operation point, we can compare the productivity of that particular equipment or machinery with competitors' machinery. Then appropriate automation of production process is also most important. Then effectiveness of control system to improve the quality and reduce the cost of that particular production process. And third one, that is efficiency of plant layout and work flow design of that particular processing activity. Okay, so this is the next activity, that is operation. This operations activity is nothing but the processing activity. Okay, okay, after service activity, we study the next part, that is support activity. Okay, so this support activity assists the primary activities in accomplishment of goal of that particular organization. Okay, so this support activity involve different types of activity. In that first one, that is procurement. Second activity, that is technology development. Third activity, that is human resource management. And fourth one, that is infrastructure. Okay, we see one by one the support activity. In that first activity, that is procurement activity. So this procurement is the process of acquiring various resource inputs to the primary activities, that is called as procurement activity. So these procurement activities are related with the collection of that particular various inputs for primary activity. Okay, so this procurement activity serves the organization by supplying all the necessary inputs like material, machinery or other consumable items that are required by the organization for performing primary activities. Okay, so in case of procurement, we see some important points like source of material, which is most important, then time, cost and quality of that particular material, then procedure of procurement and relationship with reliable suppliers. These are the some important points included in procurement activity. Okay. In short, procurement is the process of acquiring or collection of various resources or inputs which are used in primary activities. After procurement activity, next activity, that is technology development. Okay, so in this technology development, at present this technology development required heavy investment and which take years for the research and development. However, the benefits of that particular investment or technological development can be enjoyed for several years and by the multitude users in the that particular organization. Okay, so there are the key technologies which are attached to different activities which may be directly linked with product or with process or with resource input. So this technological development is directly related with product or with production process or with input or resources which are used in that particular production process. Okay, some important points related to technological development. We must study regarding the technological development is the success of research and development environment in that particular organization, then quality of lab and other facilities, then ability of work environment and qualification and experience of technical hands. These all points are included in technology development. After technology development, next activity in value chain, that is human resource management. Okay, so this human resource management is the most common and most important activity which excel the all primary activities in that particular organization. Okay, so this human resource management, it is the most common and most important activity which is linked with all the primary activities in that particular organization. Okay, this human resource management encompasses the overseeing the selection, then retention, promotion, transfer, appraisal, dismissal of staff. Okay, so in case of human resource management, it covers the selection of person, then retention, promotion of that particular personnel, then transfer, appraisal and dismissal of that particular top. All these activities are covered under this human resource management. Okay, so this human resource management is an area involved with recruiting, managing, training, developing, rewarding people within the organization. Okay, so these all are included in human resource management. Okay, while studying this human resource management activity, some important points in which first one, that is effectiveness of recruitment and training procedure, then appropriateness of reward system, then relationship with trade unions, and last point, that is level of employees motivation and job satisfaction must be considered while human resource management. Okay, After human resource management, next activity that is infrastructure or firm's infrastructure. So this management system which provide its services to the whole organization and includes planning, finance, information management, quality control, legal and government affairs, etc. Okay, so in this infrastructure we also consider the all physical property or all the physical assets in that particular organization. Okay, while studying this infrastructure activity, we see some important points, that is coordination and integration of that particular organization, then level of information system, quality of that particular planning system, and timely and accurate information on the environment. These all are included in infrastructure activity of value chain analysis. Okay, in the fast paced world, the main focus of organization is the consumer satisfaction. Okay, and this value chain analysis is the technique that helps to attain that particular level. Okay, under this, each business activity is considered as a essential activity which contribute value and is constantly analyzed to increase the value as regard to cost incurred. Okay, so in case of any organization, main focus of any organization is the consumer satisfaction, and to achieve that particular consumer satisfaction, this value chain technique is help or most important. Okay, so this is all about the value chain analysis. It includes basically primary activity and secondary activities. So these primary activities are directly linked with product or conversion of that particular input into the output or distribution activity, that is primary activity. And support activity, this support activity help the primary activity for achievement of goal of that particular organization. Okay, so this is all about value chain analysis. Okay, so after this session, there is one assignment to you student. So you have to select any one agribusiness industry or any one organization and prepare the value chain analysis likewise. In the next slide, you see the one example, that is Walmart value chain. So you have to see the in Walmart value chain analysis, inbound logistic, then operation, outbound logistic, marketing and sale activities, and different services which are given by that particular Walmart. And also there are some supporting activities we see in this diagram, that is procurement activity, technological development, human resource management, and last one is firm infrastructure. Okay, so you have to prepare one value chain analysis of any agro-based industry which is available to nearest place. Okay, so this is all about value chain analysis. Okay, thank you all.